something like this that allows for creative expression and the sharing of all that is creative and beautiful and different and artistic deserves a big round of applause. So shall we start with that? Thank you. Thank you all for being here tonight. Your support means everything to us. To just tell you a little bit about Creative Future, I believe it means chit chat in Japanese, yes? And it started off in Tokyo in 2003, and since then has spread over 400 cities all over the world, and it's now in Colombo. And this is the first of four? Yeah, this is the first of four editions, so it's really great that all of you are here, get a feeling for what all of this is about. Go back, tell your friends, and bring them along for the next one. And also remember that every time Pecha Kucha happens, the location will change, the theme will change, the presenters will change. Talking about the presenters, we've got eight of them here with us this evening who are going to do their presentations to you on the 2020 format, 20 slides in 20 seconds each, and we'll get to them later on. But Pecha Kucha is a non-profit initiative, and you have to know that every cent from tonight goes to act to rehabilitate Sri Lanka, and later this evening Michelle will be sharing a presentation on ACT on the Pecha Kucha format, so look forward to that. We also need to thank and show our gratitude to the Warehouse Project, our venue for the evening. The Warehouse Project has been involved with a lot of voluntary stuff that's been going on around this area. They've got different programs that help single parent households. That they're not really asking for your funds or your money, just that you come over here, spend some time, and help these children. You know, with just general stuff, whatever you can pitch in, because your time spent with them is as important as anything else, right? So thank you to the Warehouse Project for having us this evening. And that's them playing over there. Before we go any further, that this evening would not be possible without the support of all of our sponsors, who I'd like to thank right now. Triad, Cargill's, MTV and NBC, the Widgeon News Group, Softwave Printing, Dynamic AV Technologies, Flipit Media, the Saskia Fernando Gallery, GTS, Coco Miranda, Odlo, VFX, Sound Asia, and Frames TV and Film. So those are all of our sponsors, and a very big thank you to them. I like to know that you are with us, with me, with what's happening here. So before we move on to our first presenter this evening, we have another round of applause just so that the evening is going on, and it's good in here. Thank you! We'll try and do better than that later on this evening, but doing great so far. So we're going to bring on our first presenter for the evening. She is a designer, an artist, a dancer, and curator. She grew up in Kurnagala, but lives and works in Colombo now. And she's here to talk about her fashion label, Flower Power. So, ladies and gentlemen, here's Dinette. Give it up for her.
This is my dad. His name is Murisinghe Adarajide. He's a very famous artist in 1990s in Colombo. And he is my only inspiration. I'm here on this stage today thanks to him. because he is everything that I am here today, and he's a big inspiration of my life. And he still works and lives as an artist in the studio. So this is the studio that I was living and working in Kathmandu, with seven wonderful artists, and it was an open art house. So 24/7 we made art and we promote art. And I also live with an amazing rabbit, which represents in all of my art and clothing today. If you see my art paintings and my clothes, you will see a rabbit, and that's it. So this is my painting. My specialty is I paint on sheetha. It's a Sri Lankan traditional material, flowery textile, already printed. The challenge is to paint on top of that what I see or what I imagine. So even as a viewer, you have to go in kind of adventure to see that. And this is my first project called Living Canvas, born in Nepal, Kathmandu. We created three-dimensional art form that can exhibit on human bodies and on a stage. So this was a successful project that I started with Nepali artists. And then we were invited to show the artwork in Colombo, which we came 2007 and worked with seven Sri Lankan artists and exhibited our living canvas in Gopeng Hotel. And this is the Sri Lankan artist who created this thing. It was an amazing piece, and it was the first time in South Asia this kind of show happened. And we've been aired in BBC News South Asia twice, radio and internet. And then we were invited in Bhutan to do for the fifth king coronation to work with seven Bhutani artists, where we created, and this is my favorite piece, one of the Bhutani artists did it as monk, as punk, because even if you are Buddha or if you are bad person, you have Buddha living inside yourself. So I love trains, I love traveling. Being in a 72-hour train in India is the time, only time that I inspired myself. Like being with so many strangers for 3 days in a train, that's my best part to make ideas, to make new paintings and in clothing. So this is when I was traveling in India. And my first collection was born in New Delhi, where I created only overcoat jackets with sheetha textile and painting on them. Where I had this fashion show was in the Living Room Cafe. It was a small village of artists called Hostess Village. And they had one cafe and we did the fashion show there. So I always do my paintings and my fashions together, because I see my own fashion, my colors, through my own painting. So I want to always show that this fashion coming through my art. So I always show painting as my background and then my fashion in front of it. And this is where I work, my uncle. All my fashion is made in Kurunagalar. This is my uncle who's a uniform maker, but now he's working with me making totally female clothes. And also he's teaching me. He's my fashion design teacher. I'm not educated with any big institution. And this is my village, one of my teachers. Actually, see, we are cheetahs at home. This is villagers. Everybody, we are cheetahs. This is what I want to show, like, in the villages, people are beautiful and colorful and using this amazing colorful cheetah. But if a young girl wears it, they laugh at you. They think you are like from Bode, some village. And this is, I see the contrast and energy of cheetah. If they are with the other random clothes, cheetah is always sticking out and it brings amazing energy in you. So I want to promote why from not only Sri Lanka but all around the world to wear cheetah, because it makes you happy and bring it out. So this is my first collection, men collection. These two pieces been selected to show in the Ethical Fashion Show in Paris this year. So I'm really happy of these two collections actually, because this is first time I'm internationally showing my card. And also I'm recycling each material and make jewelry out of it, you can see. And these are the patchwork trousers I made, and this collection was 2009. And this photo is taken in Teta, and also the model is a random person. She's a singer and a student, and she's my friend. I like using random people to wear my clothes because it brings the real meaning that I'm talking about. This collection came out last Saturday. I launched it. It's called Apit Kolumbakello. Actually, my favorite song is Apit Kolumbakello, one of the 1960s famous Sinhalese songs. So as a reply in fashion, I created this short saying Apit Kolumbakello. So you can buy them in Melache, the shop in Colombo. And this is the launch last Saturday at Gothe Institute through the Coca Collective artists. And my paintings and the models, all my friends, and representing Apis Colombatello and Colo. So you can go to buy them in Malache in Duplication Road. And as finally, I want to say that believe in your work and find your own heart on your own dream, and always try to do something that you have never done before. And buy your power, flower power, and be loved, and love everybody. So thank you.
Beautiful, thank you. Next up, if you've been spotting any cool, so here's Pragit Manohansa. He's the artist responsible for some of these cool sculptures that he's going to share with you right now. He lives in Gampaha, and his work is displayed at the Saskia Fernando Gallery, so go check it out when you can. But right now, here's Pragit.
මේ ඉන්නේ ප්‍රගීත් මනෝහංස. ප්‍රගීත් මනෝහංස ගැන මම පිටස්තරයක් විදිහට මම කතා කරන්න කැමතියි. ප්‍රගීත් මනෝහංස ගොඩාක් දුරට කරන්නේ පරණ යකඩ එකතු කරලා පදන මූර්ති ප්‍රතිමාවන් නිරන්තරයෙන් කරන්නේ. ඉතින් ප්‍රගීත් මනෝහංසගේ ඔළුවට එන අදහස් කොච්චර ගාන මේ තියෙන්නේ මේ උදළු වලින් හදපු කම්කරුව පිරිසක් පිළිවෙල කරන මූර්තියක්. මේක විද්‍යාදාස එක්ස්පොසිෂන් එකේදී මම මේක ඉදපත් කරා. ප්‍රගීත් මනෝහංස මේ උදැල්ලක් අරන් තියෙන්නේ උදැල්ලක් ගෙවිලා තියෙන ගෙවිච්ච උදැල්ල. මේ ගෙවිච්ච උදළු වලට මිනිහෙක් මැදිහත් වෙලා කරපු ක්‍රියාවක් අරගෙනවා. ඒ වගේම මේ තියෙන්නේ ප්‍රගීත් මනෝහංස කරන වර්ක්ෂොප් එකේ වැඩ ටික. ඒ කියන්නේ යාට ඕනේ තව කෙනෙක් එක්කම කරගන්න වැඩ ගන්න. මොකද යාට පස්සට ගිහලා බලන්න මොකක් හරි කෑල්ලක් ඇදුණොත් එහේ මේ කෑල්ලේ मुल कृतियम हेडे विनास्तेन प्रगीत मन हदबु खम यूनियन लीड के मतुकृत मे सवल मुनरे हदलती मुनरे आडंबर मुनरा पील निशा मुनरा पील मुनर पील मिर्माण कल सवल लड़ी सवल सवल खम खम चरती मिथन मे मे हेम वील मे क्यार्टर्स चरित मे हेम वील लुक पोटी सामाजे लुक लुक हेम पोटी मिनस लुक मिनस एक्टा सामाज मिगमानी मेक हदवे मेक मोटल लेगा मेक लुकोट हदंड हदबू मोटल लेगा मेक मे बुलेट सोलिंग हदंड हदंड अदहस कर मे युद्ध पास युद्ध पावित कर बुलेट्स एक्ल साम संगीत परयक निर्माण करता मगे अदाहमेंद चूटी मूर्ति अकमें मेके निधरम स्कैचल आसकरण प्रगीत मनोहंस स्कैच निरंतर करण स्कैचल उलोटी नाथ योम कोले कटारे कोले कोले निरंतर स्कैच करण ये स्कैचल तत्समें मेती है मे हेम करबू स्कैच पास्ते निर्माण मूर्ति मे तीय मेकदी हम सरल क्या कीपैक हदकू हरके आकृत्या मेक उड़ोट मेके मूवेंट हेडतल ये अरगण तीयनी रवायण कथाकनी पड़ी पड़ी दुर्ल तीन प्रभावी कथाकर अड्डी एक कनगाट विन पूर्वा मित्र कथाकर मे को कदल दी मेक हदंड क्यान एक्कर विधि मेक मल सवाल हदप मल एक सवाल राशि कंपर राशि इकन हदपू मला हदन हदपू स्कैची मेक फस्ट बल मे मेके हदप कृति मेती कृति मेक मे उस फल ये दिग ये गेलपेन सैज हदल दी मे मेक मे ගරායකා කියන කියන්නේ ප්‍රගීත් මනෝහර දැකලා තියෙනවා ඒ දවස්වල ගරායකා නිරන්තරයෙන්ම ඔය ලෙවල් වඩු මේවා ඒවට ඒවා ගොඩක් දුරට යන්නේ හිතට වැදිලා තියෙනවා ඒ නිසා ඒ ආශ්‍රයෙන් කරපු නිර්මාණ තමයි මේ වගේ දේවල් ඒ ස්කෙච් එක කලින් දැක්කේ මේ තියෙන්නේ ඒකෙන් හදපු ප්‍රතිනාවෙත් තව තව එකක් මේ වගේ මේ ගණ දෙයියෝ ගණ දෙයියන්ට ගොඩක් කැමති ගණ දෙයියෝගේ ඇක්ෂන් වලට ගොඩක් කැමති යා ගොඩාක් දුරට ගණ දෙයියන්ගේ සීරියස් එක දිගටම කරායි කරපු ස්කිට් එකෙන් පස්සේ හදපු එකක් තමයි මේ තියෙන්නේ මේකදී වියග්‍රේ මෙයාව හදලා තියෙන්නේ යකඩ වාහන පාට තමයි ගොඩාක් දුරට මෙන්න නබුල් කෑල් ඒක ගොඩාක් දුරට මේකට උපයෝග කරගෙන තියෙනවා මේකෙන් මේ කැංගරුව මෙදී මේකෙන් පස්සේ හදපු ඒ ස්කෙච් එකෙන් පස්සේ හදපු මූර්තිය මේ මේක මාල දිවිනේදී එහේ ජනාධිපතිතුමාගේ මේ ගරාජ් දිවි ඉඳන් කරපු දෙයක් මේක ඔක්කොම ඒගොල්ලන්ගේ වාහනවල පාර්ට්ස් තමයි මේකට උපයෝග කරගත්තේ මේ මේ චරිත මේ විවිධ පැත්තට හැරිලා විවිධ පැත්තට මොහොන දෙන චරිත කීපයක් තමයි මේ තියෙන්නේ මේකේ ගොඩක් දුරට කැපෙන චරිත එක තරඟ දෙකක් වෙලා පිළිම කළ දෙක දෙයි
Next, we have a group of three incredibly creative young people, Naveen, Dinesh, and Randula, who spend their days working on web designing, studying commerce and economics. But they are the first people in Colombo to have worked on a local street art project. They call themselves Matavada, and they're here to make their presentation now. So give it up for them.
Check. Okay, guys. We are Matavada, and this is Naveen. This is Randula and Dinesh. Basically, we'll take you through the story of Matavada. It's actually something that represents people expressing their ideas, their creative ideas, everything. So it actually started off as a blog where a couple of people got together, started off writing stuff, and then eventually went off to something bigger than a blog. So the blog actually was something not just the three of us did. It's something, it was a collective effort where so many people actually contributed. And some of the people who actually been there were these people. So eventually the blog actually went off to something better. We started experimenting with different stuff. And one of the outcomes was a music project called The Bass Factor, right? And that was an electronic music project which two of us got together and just did it off and put it online. The actual foundation for this was actually laid years back when we were in college. We actually, three of us started off a music project called The Parole, where we just experimented with stuff, softwares. No one was there to teach us. And what you can see here are some of the handmade copies that we gave out to friends. Then we actually moved on to some visual experimentations. I think Dinesh will take you through some of the stuff we have done so far.
First video project used to be this one, The Bridge at Seoul, is back in 2006 actually. It's like just after finishing A levels, me, Naveen, and there's another guy who migrated to USA, Hendrik Puthipanamana. We three got together and shot a small short film about a gangster and his conscience in my hometown, Maharagama. It is our first cinematic experience we had with the camera, and then we move on to the feature films. This is like the first ever Sri Lankan metal music documentary called Arise. The idea came to this by Naveen, is a huge metal fan and he had some connections to the band. So we started the project in 2009 and shot entirely like 8 or 9 gigs in and around Colombo, and this is the one image of a gig in Kandy we shot. And we compiled a 1.5 hour long documentary and released it in 2010, July, at Allianz Francis. The premiere was attended by the fans as well as the band members. And at that date, we released a film DVD. And the cover was inspired by street art, a type of street art which is fair paint stencils. And it was also one of the side projects of Matavada, which was carried out in 2009. And basically, we got stencils like Monroe and Jimi Hendrix. They were pre-made stuff, not our own stuff. Then we cut out and spray painted. Then we move on to do our own stuff, like this quotation of Marilyn Monroe, as well as the title of a song of Jimi Hendrix. Then we want to add some Sri Lankan depth to it as well, Sri Lankan art. And then we thought of adding classical Sri Lankan film stills. On your right side is Nidane, as well as on the left you can see Gamparadiya. So only places you can see our art, the remaining places are one place in Maharagama and another one is inside University of Colombo. Then we move out to the fashion design.
Well, yeah, taking after our Sridhar experience, we got it up to clothing items, actually not for any commercial purposes, but just to kind of vary something different. So this is a t-shirt that is made with stencil spread on with the still of Nidane, medical film. It went up on Art Walk in 2009, where we portrayed several of our artists, and the day of this event, the day before this event, a little bizarre because our outfits weren't colorful enough and we had to revisiting at the last moment, but it came out really well, and that was one of our projects that we carried out in 2009. The Kinsu Cinema Show is the most recent project. It was a screening of two movies which happened this June. These two movies were directed by Dinesh, and the cast was from the University of Colombo, where both Dinesh and I studied currently. And this was the first film which went up on the screen at this cinema show, The Killing Poem. It revolves around the life of a poet who is building enough skill for her writing. And the second movie that was screened at the Kinsu Cinema Show was Mother Kinsu Nana Mobile Psychedelic Other, Me Man No Mobile Psychedelic Love. Just as the title hints, it was a very bizarre movie. It talks about a youth who becomes insane because of a missed call that he received from a girl, a completely unknown and strange girl. And we also released a music video along with this movie titled I Wish, featuring Jesu Arunrada, a very talented undergraduate at our university. And this is also the official soundtrack of the second movie that went up on screen at the Kinsu Cinema Show. The music and the composition, the lyrics is all done by Jesu for that song. And what you see here is a gadget that we came up with for the shooting of these two movies. It's a camera stabilizer. It's made out of PVC pipe, and we were inspired by a YouTube video. And we came up also with a light stand and stuff on our own like that.
Yeah, I think in terms of future projects, we are just going to go ahead with whatever comes in our way. I think mostly the people who are around us and people who have come across us and people who have actually contributed us are the ones that make us do what we do. So we actually want to thank everyone who have been part of Matavada. It's not just three of us, it's just a bunch of all other people. And Pechakucha also especially for giving us this opportunity, because these are the kind of events that would promote artists and creative ideas like this. So thank you very much.
As I said before, every cent that's made on the first edition of Pechakucha goes to ACT, to rehabilitate Sri Lanka. To tell you a bit more about ACT, it was established in the year 2009, and Pechakucha selected this organization keeping the schools in the north and east in mind. So this evening, Michelle has taken on the brave task of sticking to the Pechakucha format of 2020 to talk to you about everything it possibly can, that ACT is involved with and has been involved with in the recent past. So here's Michelle.
Hi, I'm Michelle and I'm here to introduce Action and Care Trust, Active Rehabilitate. We started just before the war ended, working with those that were adversely displaced by the war. We wanted to improve their quality of life and work on a plan to rebuild their future. We're not just one person, we're a group of volunteers and friends that came together in that hour of need. Radhika, Hiranjan, Nisha, Krishni and myself spearheaded it, together with Professor Sharifuddin, who came on as our chairperson. But as you can see, it's a volunteer group effort very much. This picture on the left is why we started. This girl was brought to Lady Ridgeway Hospital with an amputee. And we all have kids, and when we saw her, we realized we had to do something. The picture on the right was 1 week later at Wavonia Hospital, and these people were desperate. They had no idea what was happening. They had nowhere to go. Professor Sharif's team brought a lot of professional medical assessments to what we were doing, and here he is in Wavonia Hospital assessing the actual ground situation. There were 8,000 people receiving medication at this hospital the day he visited. And one of the things we did was we gave what wasn't going to the hospitals. One major concern was, will things get lost, will things get stolen, your donations? So we ensured delivery by inventorizing everything and actually following every vehicle that was going into the security zones, into the camps, meeting with the doctors and personally handing everything over. This map gives you an idea of the areas we worked in. Wavonia and the middle area is the receiving hospitals, and then we moved further up north to Manik Farm, and now we're happy to say we're working with children and schools in Mulapivu, Kilinochi, Punarin, and the Jaffna Peninsula. Hygiene was a huge issue at Manik Farm and a lot of the camps, and one thing we were able to do was to bring Learn Asia into the picture, and they worked with the local authorities and with everyone in the camp to educate them on the importance of hygiene and how to deal with this amount of waste. This is Dr. Ishanka. I mean, this is a tented hospital in Manik Farm. They used to deliver babies and do minor surgeries under this canvas tent. It was like a furnace here. She used to come to work 3 hours every day from Anuradhapura. We did a lot to also support the health services at this stage. While going into Manik Farm, we saw hundreds and thousands of children. They were idle, they had nothing to do, they had no idea how long they were going to be in these camps. So we brought art supplies, we had sports meets, drama days, musical shows. They put on similar musical festivals. This is a typical regional hospital, divisional hospital along the A9 down Elephant Pass, and as you can see, bombed out, no electricity after 6, so we visited each of these hospitals and identified what they needed and started to work with them at this regional level. We received this award for the contribution we had done. We're not an NGO, we're just a group of citizens that got together, and this made it clear to us that we were making a difference, and it made our commitment to continue the work we're doing, and right now we're going to focus on the future and the next generation. During the recent floods in January, the Disaster Management and Health Ministry called upon our services, and this is actually taken from our medical vehicle that went in, and they had to get disbanded and get onto this boat. That's about 16 feet of water. This is en route to Amparo and Vaticolo. The future right now for us is very much in children. Education, give them what we take for granted in Colombo. So this is a before and after of Punarin Mahavidyalaya. We've opened this in February 2011 and we've got plans to do this in all the main schools in the north. On my visit in April, it rained the day we visited these schools. These are some of the small schools in Punarin, and these kids on the left hand side are actually doing classwork there. They're all dressed up and come to school, and a little bit of help will go a long way for their schooling life. So this is a part of where our funds are going to. This is why we're doing and the fundraising and what we do. We build centers like this where we give them, you know, competitive sports, musical equipment, art supplies, a lot of English books because they're very keen on learning English. And this is where all the fundraising is going to go, to building more facilities like this. The Scouts movement hasn't actually been present in Vermont for about the last 25 years because of the war. And we have a pilot project set to launch in September, 50 students in Poonaway, 50 boys, and we're really looking forward to taking the Boy Scouts back into Vermont. This picture on the left is the sunset at Point Pedro on the beach, and this is the sun setting on the way back from Poonarim to Jaffna. I picked these two because before the war ended, you never got a chance to see the sunset. There was a curfew and children went undercover at that point. So this is key and this is the future. Today there are canvases here to my right. Please, if you haven't had an opportunity to get up and paint a bit, do. We're going to auction this off at the end of 1 year. All the proceeds are going towards the projects you just saw. So please do make the effort to fill up the space. And there'll be more at the next event. You can follow our work on our website. We did have a box at the front to put your business cards in if you'd like to stay in touch. Use the opportunity to speak to me after this event. We have 3 centers planned for Mulapulu and we've just got security clearances to go in there. So there's a lot of work planned for the rest of the year. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Pechakucha because this is the platform we need. All the ticket sales that you all purchased today go towards the work we're doing, so thank you.
Okay guys, break time's over, so we don't mind you buying food at the back, but can we at least have some silence in here? Because our next presenter is about to go on. So, Harsha Madhuranga is a photographer by profession, and this evening he's going to talk to you about his passion, which is portraits, and here's Harsha. Hopefully, when you get up here, they'll start listening.
මම චාරිත්‍රාත්මක විදිහට ලෝකයේ අඳුරගත්ත පළමු මිතුරුණා ගොඩක් මේ දකින්නේ මීට අවුරුදු 10 කලින් 2001 වසරේදී හාවැලි ප්‍රදේශ විගත්තේ මගේ හැම පින්තූරයකටම මිනිස් රූපයක් සම්බන්ධ වෙනවා මේ දකින්නේ ඒ වගේ එකක් මිනිස් රූපයක් නැති පින්තූරයක් ගන්න එක මම දැන් අමාරුයි මම දන්නා ඒ කියලා මේ ගත්තේ ඔස්ට්‍රියාවේ වෙස්බන් හොක් ස්ටේෂන් එකේ තනන්නක ඇතුළේදී ජීවිතේ වේගය අපි දකිනවා මේ මම උත්සාහකමේ වගේ එක අවස්ථාවක් ගියවලුද මගේ පළවෙනි වන් මෑන් ෂෝ එක තිබුණා ඒකේ තිබුණ පින්තූර කීපයක් මේ දකින්නේ අපි නතර වුණාට අපි පහු කරලා ලෝකේ යනවා මේ ඇවිදින මේ මොනස්ෙක් වුණාට එයාව පහු කරන් බාහිර ලෝකේ ගමන් කරනවා මේ පිටිපස්සෙන් බස් එකකින් මම සංකේතවත් කරන්න උත්සාහ කරේ ඒක අපි ලෝකේ කොයි පැත්තක හිටියත් මේ ධර්මතාවය හැමෝටම පොදුයි ජීවිතේ රෝගයක් වගේ රුධිරයක් තියෙනවා උදේ ඉඳලා පායන හවස පහිනවා අපි හුස්ම ගන්න හැම දෙයක්ම එක්තරා රටාවක වෙන්නේ මේ තියෙනක දෙයක් ලෝක තවත් පැත්තක් මේ ලිම්ස් වල ජීවිතේ මංපා චක්‍රාකාරයෙන් මං දකිනවා මේ මම දකපු ලයිෆ් සර්කල් කීපයක් චක්‍ර කීපයක් මේ ලේඩි ෆොටෝග්‍රාෆර් කෙනෙක් මෙයා ඉන්නේ ලිම්ස් වල මෙයාගේ විශේෂත්වයක් තිබුණා ලංකාවේ අපිට නියුඩ් ෆොටෝග්‍රාෆි කියන එක ටිකක් අමුතුයි ටිකක් වෙනස් හැබැයි මෙයාගේ නියුඩ්ස් බොහොම එකේ ඉන්නේ මෙයාගේ දුව ලස්සන නියුඩ්ස් කීපයක් තිබුණා මෙයාගේ ස්ටුඩියෝ එකේ ඒ හැමයක්ම මෙයා අරන් තිබුණේ මෙයාගේ දුවගේ මේක ගත්ත චෙන්නයි වලදී චෙන්නයි නගරේ ජනාකීර්ණ නගරයක් ඒ වුණාට ඒ ජනාකීර්ණ භවෙන් මිදිලා හුදකලා පුද්ගලයෙක් මට පොදු කරගන්න පුළුවන් වුණා මේක ප්‍රධාන වර්ණ තුනයි දකින්නේ සුදු කළු සහ අළු තමයි දකින්නේ සහ හුදකලා බව මම සංකේතවත් කරන මේ බිඳුවේ හිමනල්ල අපිට කවදාකවත් හිමනල්ල මතරින්න බෑ අපි කොතන ගියත් අපේ පස්සේ හිමනල්ල එනවා මේ උපේ පාන්දරයට ඒ චෙන්නයි නගරේ අපේ ජීවිතේ හිමනල්ල දකිනවා ඒ වගේම මේ සුදු පාට බැලන්ස් කරන්න මම පිටිපස්සෙන් දෙන කාර් එක යොදා ගන්න උත්සාහ කරනවා චෙන්නයි වල හිටපු ඉන්දර්වි මම හිතන අවුරුදු 3 4ක් වගේ ඇති මගේ දුවගේ වයස මේ උදේ ගෙනියන්නේ වතුර එයාගේ ගෙදරට ජීවිතේ අපි දකින විදිහ ගැති කීපයක් තමන්ගේ ගෙදර වැනට අවුරුදු 3 මාසක දරුවෙක් තමන්ට බැරි බර උහුලගෙන යනවා මේ බැරි බර මේ මයිසූර් මයිසූර් දා නිවාඩු දවසක් මයිසූර් නගරයේ හිටපු පුද්ගලෙ මගේ පින්තූර වල මම කැමති නැහැ කෙනෙක්ව පෝස්ට් කරලා බලෙන් අරගන්න මේ ඒ කෙනා හිටපු විදිහ කිසිම ඇරේන්ජ් කිරීමක් නැහැ ඒ එතන තිබිච්ච විත්තියේ තිබුණ අපුරු ටිකක් එක්ක මම උත්සාහ කරා පොඩි බැලන්ස් කිරීමක් කරන්න මේ කාංචන මගේ ජීවිතයේ එක් සම්දිස්ථානයක් මේකට ඉන්ටර්නැෂනල් අවෝඩ්ස් ගානක් හම්බුණා ඒ අතරින් ලක්සම්බර්ග් වලින් මට හම්බුණා PCE ඩිප්ලෝමා එකක් මේ පින්තූරේට ඊට අමතරව ඔස්ට්‍රියාවේ තියෙන ඔස්ට්‍රියන් සුපර් සර්කිට් ලෝකෙම ෆොටෝග්‍රැෆි කම්පිටිෂන් එක ෆොටෝග්‍රැෆර්ස් ද ඔලිම්පික් එක ඒක ස්ටාර්ටින් පික්චර් එක විදිහට මේක තෝරගත්තා මගේ සබ්ජෙක්ට් එක පෝට්‍රේට් කියලා අපි කලින් කිව්වා මේ තව එකක් මේ ඉන්න මගේ බිරිඳ ගිය අවුරුද්දේ පික්සල් ආර්ට් කියලා මගේ වන් මෑන් එක්සිබිෂන් එක මම කරා ඒකෙදි මට ඕනුණා හයිකී සහ ලෝකී කියන ෆොටෝග්‍රැෆි වල සම්ප්‍රදායන් දෙක ඉස්මතු කරන්න අපිට හයිකී පෙන්වන්න දෙයක් නැහැ අපේ අයගේ පොඩි කඩුවේ ඒක නිසා මම ස්කාෆ් එකක් බඳලා අපි බිරිඳ කිතුලක් අරගත්තා ඒ විදිහට මේ හයිකී පිටුර මේ මගේ බින්දගේ සොහොයුරා අපේ ගිහින් ට්‍රිප් එකේදී අරගත්තා ඇරෙන්ජ් කිරීමක් නැහැ මේ සාමාන්‍ය අපි දෙකපු විදිහ සහ එයාට අනිත් අය වතුර එල්ල කරලා කරපු දෙයක් තමයි තියෙන්නේ කිසිම සංස්කරණයක් නැහැ ඇරෙන්ජ් කිරීමක් නැහැ චුරල අපි දෙකපු විදිහ මේ ලබන පින්තූර වල කීපයක් තියෙනවා මගේ ට්‍රැවල් පින්තූර මගේ ෆැමිලි පින්තූර මගේ යාළුවෝ සහ මගේ සැමියා මේ මගේ යාළුවෙක් මගේ ස්ටුඩියෝ එකක් බලන්න මට හිතෙන පෝට්‍රේට් එකක් කරන්න මට නේද ෆෑන් එකක් තිබුණ නැහැ මට ඕන නම් මේ කොණ්ඩේ උඩ ගවන්න මම කොණ්ඩේ ලෙහුවා ලෙහලා පාවිච්චි කරා පොඩි 250 GSM වගේ පොඩි A4 sheet එකක් පාවිච්චි කරලා පොඩි හුලම් පාරක් ගහලා තියෙන්නේ මේක මම බාව ඉහළට ඔසවපු එක අවස්ථාවක් මේකට හම්බුණා ඔස්ට්‍රේලියානු සුපර් සර්කිට් බෝඩ් වෙන්න එකක් ගිය අවුරුද්දේ ඇරෙන්ජ් කරලා නැහැ මම උත්සාහ කරේ මේ කපල් එකේ පින්තූර අරගන්න ඒත් මම දැක්කා ඒ වෙලාවට මේ පොඩි ළමයි ටික වෙනස් වෙනවා අර දැක්කම මේකට හම්බුණා ෆොටෝග්‍රාෆර්ස් ලා ඔලිම්පික් එකේ බෝඩ් වෙන්න එකක් ලංකාවට වෙච්ච එක අවස්ථාවක් වෙඩින් ෆොටෝග්‍රාෆර් අම්මච්චි ප්‍රස්තයි මේ දෙවෙනි පින්තූරේ පිට පිට අවුරුදු දෙකක් මේක මම අරගත්තේ ගෝල්ඩ් ප්ලේස් හොටෙල් එකේදී වෙඩින් එක ඉවරලා පින්තූර ගත්තාන් පස්සේ කපල් එකත් කරයි අයි පින්තූර ගන්න පුතුරු නැහැ ඇඳුමක් अरेंज करें ना मांगने की उतने लोगों की उतने लोगों को रेल लगता हुआ मां मास मायवान तो उन्हें एक एक मोते छापे घर का अंदर गान देंगे मैं पंप पे असल असल वैसे मैं वह बैठकर पुत गले इस तरह मनोहर से कि वो काम कर लोगे ये एक वाले बैठकर पुत गले मैं आगे मुंह में तो बना बंग आशा करें मैं गाते कर मैं हेड के जाते के संकेत वाले के ना यहाँ बैठकर उपाव ඒක නිසා මම මූලික ફોકસ නොකර මගේ ફોકસ එක මම දුන්නේ අද්දෙකට අද්දෙකටම මම මූලික වස්තුව කරගත්තේ මේක මේ තවත් ඒ විදිහ පුද්ගලයෙක් අපේ ගෙවල් කිට්ටු ඉන්නේ ගෙදර මොකක්ද වැඩක් තිබුණොත් ඒවට සම්බන්ධ වෙනවා ඒවිල්ලා උදව් වෙනවා උදව් වෙලා මම සයිනවා බොහොම අහිංසක මිනිස්සෙක් අනික මම අත බොහොම කැමති බ්ලැක් ඇන් වයිට් පින්තූර වලට මේ මගේ එක්සිබිෂන් එකේ තිබිච්ච මම කොට ලෝකී මේ ලෝකී එකට මම අරගත් එක පින්තූරයක් මේ අවුරුදු 18කට පස්සේ ලංකාවට හම්බුණා FIAP bronze medal එක. ඒක හම්බුනේ මට මේක තිබුණේ 2005 අවුරුද්දේ. මේක නෙදර්ලන්ඩ් වලින් තමයි පිරිනමන්නේ. මේකදී මම උත්සාහ කරා මේ පින්තූරෙන් ගරාමයට අතීතයේ එරෙහිව නැගීම උත්සාහ කරන තරුණ දුවෙක් ඉන්න තාත්තා කෙනෙක්ගේ සිහිනයක්. මේ එයාගේම තව පින්තූරයක්. මේක best 100 portraits of the world වලට ගේන්නා ගිය අවුරුද්දේ. මේක තිබුණේ ස්ලෝවේනියාවේ. මේ වංශය මරුණා මේක හරියට මාචර කලින් මරුණා මම චාරු ශිල්පියෙක් විදිහට මාව ඉහළට ගේන්න මෙයාගේ මූණ ගොඩක් මට උදව් වුණා මම අද මේ වෙලාවේ එයා බොහොම ගෞරවයෙන් සිහිපත් කරනවා මේක හර්ෂ මොදුරංග අපි හැමෝටම හිණ තියෙනවා මටත් කීන කීපයක් තිබුණා බලාපොරොත්තු තිබුණේ ආයුබෝවන් කෙනෙක් වෙන එක අම්මා එවතුන් නැහැ ඒක අන්තිම ඉන්ටර්වියු එකේ නතර වුණා ඊට පස්සේ ඩිසයින් එකේ නැතුණා ඩිසයින් කර කර ඉද්දි හොබී එක ෆොටෝග්‍රේ පටන් ගත්තා හොබී එක පටන් ගන්න ෆොටෝග්‍රේ පික් අද වෙනකොට වෘත්තිය වෙලා තියෙනවා
award. And she's working hard on her ethical fashion label, the House of Lanali. And she's here, all hyped up and ready to talk to you about what she does, Lanali.
born in 1987, live in Colombo, and I school at Visakha Vidyalaya, and I'm studying fashion at the moment at Academy of Design. But to tell you who I am, my mother said I'm really stubborn, and I'm quite crazy and messy, short. My friends said I'm bossy, kind of creative too. To tell you, I wanted to do designing, and this is how I started. I was so bad at drawing, so I used to copy illustrations and figures from books, and I used to draw whatever the tops I wanted and gave it out and got it stitched. As you can see, it's quite horrible. I didn't know how to do art. I was bad at it. But then I decided to go to Design CS, my aunt's design studio, to learn creative and what design is exactly. I started doing little wall hangings like butterflies and fishies and stuff, which made me earn a little bit of pocket money also. But it was a time to be qualified. So then I went to Academy of Design to do my degree. 20 seconds is not enough to say about the work I did at AOD, but definitely that's the place I developed my own style. As you can see, the way I have improved my illustrations. I'm going to talk about a specific project I did at AOD. It's called U-Turn. It's a project, it's a collection that we had to do for an eco brand launched by the Apparel Association Forum. It was a competition, plus they were selecting a winner. So I decided to use all apparel industrial waste for my collection, and I decided to go to Pamulwa to find my material. I didn't want to buy the usual fabric pieces and cut pieces and stuff. I was looking for the most odd and the interesting material. I found buttons, zippers, labels, different things, but all waste. They used to call me Mahanagara Sabha Venkanavakeda. And this is one outfit that I did. The top is made out of totally waste labels, waste tips. And the skirt is a U-turn outfit in my life. It was made out of all brand labels. It was supposed to be waste. But halfway through the assignment, they said it's illegal to use other people's brand labels. So I had to go look for an alternative. Then I found size, Kya label, made in Sri Lanka labels, but it was not enough because they use it for repeat orders. I couldn't find enough for my design. So I went on looking. I didn't give up. I'm aggressive. So I went on looking. The only place I could go was a label manufacturing factory. And there was this interesting, totally suitable material inside a waste bin. And they didn't have the label because it was a salvage of the label. So I thought, okay, I totally won the competition, but sadly I didn't. Then after a while, I saw this application on the paper saying there's an ethical award competition going on. So I decided to put an application. It was like a lot of things to write. I didn't even have a brand. I just put my nickname and just gave it a try. I saw my name on the papers and I got an email saying I was selected as one of the semi-finalists. Then I had to do a collection within 8 days, eight-piece collection in 8 days. It was like happy but so terrified with the news that I have to make a new collection. But I somehow managed. I went to Pamulwa as usual and got my waste material. This is the next outfit which I did for the SLDF with the label, exact label waste. You cannot see a brand in it. Other than that, I used Mobilon tapes, buttons, zippers, everything in this collection. And at that night was a dream night for me. I won the ethical award. And I was so proud to win it with so, like there were all the others were professionals and I was the only student among them. And even with my own lecturer, I won the award. So I was quite proud. And it was just not the award, there was a long process I had to do for the next step. I had to do another new collection to London Fashion Week Aesthetica. And it was just not doing a collection this time. I had 5 months, but I had to launch my own brand. I had to launch my own business, and it was for a trade show. So it was quite a lot of work this time. So I decided to launch my brand, House of Lonali. Everybody was like, why House of Lonali? It sounds so like House of Fashion. But it's supposed to be like House of Dio or something like that. But this is my manufacturing unit, my sewing unit, my costing, my marketing, and plus managing director's office, everything here, right here. And this time, for the 2012 spring summer collection, I decided to go with labels because that's something that I spotted. And if I didn't use this, this would have been destroyed, it would have been burnt or ended up in some kind of a landfill. So that was my strong point. So I just couldn't say that I was being ethical. I had to prove it. This was the carbon footprint that I got for this specific outfit. I had to prove myself that to make this garment, this much of carbon is been emission. So this was a long process. I have to even find the information that I have to collect, how many bags I collected during this process. So here I am. It was just not the award. Through this award, I got a lot of opportunities, a lot of experience and recognition, and people started believing me and my work and what I do. So here I am with my own brand, Donali, environmental conscious design label, which creates unique, timeless fashion pieces which celebrate life and art. Thank you.
Thank you, Ronali. Our next artist for this evening, our next presenter, is an artist who'd really, honestly, much rather let her art speak for itself, but we've threatened her and therefore she's going to stick to the 2020 format and talk to you about her children's book, In Progress, I believe so. Here's Mika Tennekom.
I'm a graphic designer and illustrator based in Colombo. Today I'd like to talk about some of my illustrations. Basically this was when I had a really bad day. I started like waking up late, dropped my toes flat side down. Somewhere in the middle I got caught by my boss checking Facebook at work. Basically this was this guy I used to see at before going to work every day. I don't know if his name was Mike, but he had all these different colored shoes every single day. He left like green, pink, whatever. And I assumed on Tuesdays he wore pink. This was when I was faced in a really awkward situation at a party. I felt like the owl and this other guy, a weird monster creature, because we had nothing in common. He was talking about like, I don't know, I couldn't relate and I could, just make small talk and this is what I saw it as. This is when I had a fight with my ex-boyfriend and he told me I had changed and that got me in a really bad mood. And I seem to draw in black and white when I'm in a bad mood. And this was on a shoot. I had to work with these people who were really, really had no mercy. They didn't stop for lunch. It was a really hot day. And they kept going on at it. And I wanted to say, I'm not a robot. That's me with all those things coming out of my mouth, wanting to like yell at them, but I couldn't. This was when one of my friends actually said this line. Her parents basically didn't want her to go out, and she had to stay at home. And she said she felt like, well, she didn't say, but I thought she felt like a nun who had to stay in a cellar and, cook at home. This is when I first moved to London and everything was new and I moved into my aunt's house and I looked out and it was this big concrete jungle, and coming from Sri Lanka, there was no like familiar faces anywhere. And, that's how I felt. That's me there in the window. This was when I wanted to jump off a cliff, but I didn't, so instead I drew it. And again, it's in black and white, so there's a pattern of bad moods in black and white. This was chosen for a poster of one of my friend's bands in London. This was at a museum. They had an aquarium with jellyfish, and I kept wondering, they look so soft on top, I kept wondering what it would be like to kind of bounce off the tops of them and like run through water without obviously being killed. This is when I moved back to Sri Lanka. I felt really kind of stifled after living on your own, moving back with your parents, and so I stayed in my room, didn't go out for a while. I don't know why the birds are there, but they're there. This is another fight. That's me, and that's my ex-boyfriend's heart. I was feeling really angry when I started, and the outcome of it was this. Whatever's going on in my head, I just draw. This is when I tried to start to learn how to surf. I felt like I belonged in water, but then when I got on a surfboard, it was really awkward. I was like clinging on, trying not to drown, and I felt like the octopus who needed help, you know, with balloons to float above water. This was waiting for a tube in the morning before work. You see so many different people, and this is not actually what they look like, but in my head you see like so many different sorts of people, different characters, and you wonder like, you know, what's going on in their head. This was when I had to wait for one of my friends to turn up, and she was an hour and a half late. I was really angry, but this was the outcome. I was listening to the Beatles, so all their lyrics are everywhere. I'm kind of glad she got late. This was in India. It was so manic and crazy. The first time as I landed there, it was crazy. I just wanted the traffic light to say, you know, stop and clear everything out and have a break. But he loved it eventually. This was a book I was reading by an amazing author called Charles Bukowski. And this is a line from his book. And when I read that line, this image came into my head and I quickly drew it. And this is like a watercolor paper thing. This was something that was chosen for Topshop. They had a competition to create awareness about animals and extinction, and zebras are not extinct, but yeah. So this got in, and yeah. This was a dream I had. So basically, I'll just tell you how I work. I take a book around with me, and I just quickly jot down or do a little sketch of what inspires me. And everyday life, there's so much going on. So I quickly draw it, and then go home, work on it, scan it, and then yeah. This is my blog. Oh, if any of you want to talk to me later to do a children's book. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Nika. Before we move on to our last presenter of the evening, a few things that need mention. As you all know, this is the first time Pesha Pooja is happening in Colombo. This is the first of four editions, and this evening would not have been possible if not for the collaborative efforts of a few volunteers who all have full-time jobs but have taken time off work and come together to make this evening possible for everyone who's presented here this evening, for all of you. And they are Siobhan, Aini, is that how I pronounce it? Annie, Misairu, Salah, Dilani, Shamal, Sharon, Dennis, Jason, and even though they're not on this list, Harshi and Saskia. Thank you for all of your efforts. And guys, I've been asked to tell you, remember there's three more events to go, so don't go anywhere, don't leave the country. Thank you for your continued support. So special thank you to all of you. Can we have a big round of applause for all of them, please? And we'd also like to thank all of our sponsors once again, because as you know, as I've said before, Pesha Pooja is a non-profit initiative, and therefore we depend on our sponsors to come in and make something like this possible. So thank you, Triad, for all of the advertising, the campaign, the team of people who worked on the event. Cargill for the beer, thank you very much. MTV MBC for the publicity. The Vijay News Group for the ad space and interviews. Softwave Printing for all the posters, banners and tickets. Dynamic AV Technologies for all the equipment. Flipit Media for the website. GTS for Facebook management. Coco Veranda for the pre-event location. Odlo VFX and Sound Asia for production. Frames TV and Film Production for filming the online interviews. And of course, the Saskia Fernando Gallery. Another big round of applause for all of them, please. And now we have our final presenter for the evening. Julian is a graphic designer and marketeer. And this evening, he's here to complete Page Kucha with his presentation on dreams. So here's Julian.
Hi everyone, my name is Julian. Well, as you all know, each and every one here has their own dream, and I too, as a kid, had my own dreams. But my dreams are maybe a bit drastic. Well, I had two dreams to start off with. One is to become a cartoonist, and the other is a totally different sector altogether, which is I want to become an aeronautical engineer. So that is like from A to Z, from cartooning to aeronautical engineering. The reason I liked aeronautical engineering is because of this. I built my own radio control plane when I was just 7 with my father, and we flew it. It went out of range and it didn't come back. So, but still, it always interested me. So when I was small, when I was building it, my dad explained to me how flight works. And he always said, look at birds, look at their wing structure, look up, look at how the thrust works. And the more you look at birds, the more it's easier for you to look at planes and build it or do whatever. So I always, it fascinated me, okay, where did the birds get the energy to fly? And it came from the heart. So where did planes get the energy to drive a plane? And it was from the engines. So it really turned my eyes into engines, combustion, internal, whatever. But at the same time, the liking towards cartoons and cartooning never went away from me. From Voltron to Ninja Turtles to Thundercats to Silverhawks. I mean, I grew up with these, so this was always a dream. And I always believed in mythical art. So this guy over here, his name is Jim Henson. He is a creator of a mythical world. He is a creator of a make-believe world in reality. Usually in cartoons you see it only in TV, but he made a real, actual, mythical world by producing TV shows like The Muppet Show and Fraggle Rock and etc. So, time went past, I couldn't achieve my dream of becoming an engineer. So that was a burst of bubble. So I was grieving for some time and it was really hard for me to get out of it. So one thing that really helped me get out of it is playing the guitar, and music really transformed me to get into a better mindset. So at that time, I was obsessed with electric guitars. I just had one box guitar, that's all, which my dad gave me. So I thought, what the hell? It wouldn't be magic. And so I decided to build my own guitar. So it really opened my eyes to things that you can do if you really, really want to. So I built my guitars, I built my amplifiers, I built my guitar effects pedals, and yeah, because I really like doing it. And usually guitarists have people like Eric Johnson, Petrucci, Satriani, those are their idols. This guy over here is Floyd Pepper. He's from the Muppets, he's the guitarist from the Muppets. And he's the first guy who actually changed me into guitar. So I got my dream job, not at Sesame Street, but at
an advertising agency, which got the opportunity to do a children's educational program using Muppets. And my boss asked me, hey, can you build a Muppet? So it was a real tough task to build a Muppet because I never done Muppetry. So this is me and this is the Muppet show, which I did. It was called English Class for Me. We did about 140 episodes, which was shown on Sirasa. And the actual task of it is not the Muppet show, it's just building the Muppet. It takes a huge, huge task just to come up with the concept of it, just to come up with the ideas of it. I love to do it because it involved working with kids, and working with kids brought me back into the days of me being a kid, which helped me actually be creative and non-restrictive. So building a Muppet, it always starts with a sketch. So what, and you have always got to keep on calculating, doing the measuring in your mind, imagining the shapes, imagining whatever is going to come out of it. So it always starts with a sketch, and it doesn't stop there. Once you have the basic sketch and how your hand goes into the sock, you got to start texturing it, giving it character. What sort of attitude this Muppet is going to get? Okay, how do we portray that in color? And how do we get it to talk? What sort of accent does it need? What sort of personality it needs? So all that needs to come out once you've done it. So it's a pretty tedious task. Sometimes you need to be really creative. At the same time, me wanting to become an engineer doesn't actually apply, but you need the technical knowledge to actually sit and do this. And time passed by, I actually figured out that, you know, it's a dream of my dreams that I'm actually doing right now. And these are some of the puppets which I've made, like a very few. And yeah, it needed a lot of thinking, it needed a lot of character, visualizing skills. So yeah, so I started my own company after a while, thinking that I need to contribute this Muppets into this industry. So I pitched it to companies and asked companies to do, you know, why not a mascot for a company? Because mascots alone can go a long way. So coming back into dreams, everyone here has a dream, and everyone here is an artist. If not, you're not here. So for me, dreams do come true in an artist's eyes. Thanks.
I think among many things we've learned tonight, the most important has been that right here in Colombo, all around you, there's lots of talent. And thanks to Pedro Couto now, hopefully we have the platform, the stage for you to keep coming back and seeing more people presenting their stuff and being introduced to some lovely new art concepts. So come back in October, that's when the second edition of Pedro Couto Night Colombo happens. But thank you for being here tonight, and see you in October, hopefully. Good night.